Hello, ho, ho, ho. Shall I get really low? Hello, ho, ho, ho. Green giant. Right. So, actually, we're not on about a green giant. We're on about the red elf. Little Christmas elf. I say little Christmas elf. He varies in size, doesn't he? Old Father Christmas. In some things, he's little old, lively old elf, so all that business. And he's like a little tiny elf, a little fat one. And the other one's his great big thing, like that, you know. It's weird, isn't it? Little quick interesting fact, while we're on about drinks and Christmas and everything else, which I'm on about, by the way. Father Christmas and Santa Claus, St. Nicholas, whatever you want to call him, he didn't used to be in kind of, in red. He was in different colours, but mainly green and things like that. But he was in furs. And other times, greens, he was in furs, just furs and all that. And all sorts of different colours and that. But he was never in red until adverts, early on, they had adverts, Coca-Cola. And they'd done him in red and white. And he just stuck, you know. There's the proliferation of adverts shows the strength of mass advertising, that everyone started associating Father Christmas with red. The same as the Robin Redbreasts and that. The postman used to have red colours. They still have. They've got red in there, on their tunics and things, and on their badge and everything else. And on the vans, red vans and that. Or there was. I'm going off the thing, you know. But that was another advertising campaign thing with the Reds and everything to try to get people in Victorian times to post more letters. Letters, even. I'll posh it up now and again for the Americans. So that was Robin Redbreast. So Robins are on Christmas cards and that. And also, red kind of being associated with Christmas and that as well. Among other things, there's a lot of pagan things in Christmas as well, with holly berries and things like that, and holly red berries, isn't they? And things like that, and all sorts of other things. But anyway, I do digress. Quickly over the ones that I've done, the Christmas ones, I had a quick visit to Tesco's. Tesco's. No, they're all right. I've got the ump with where they've kind of shafted me over. Vouchers and petrol things and everything else. So often, if you know, I've gone back a day late or a day early. You fill your tank up and they go, no, that's not valid, that voucher, until tomorrow. And you go, ooh, it's small print and all that. So you know, they kind of look like they're going out of business, and I'm like, you know, I used to shop there all the time. I hardly do anymore. I go to Asda's most of the time. But went in there and they've got some good beers on. So, and they were £4 for £6. Which ain't bad, you know. So, Oh My Gosh, or Oh My God, is actually Old Miserable Git. OMG, and it's like, ball balls. And I'm like, obvious Christmas ploy, that one. It's got the Christmas holly things in the corner. Obvious Christmas ploy. It's not bad, it's a drinkable beer, but connection to Christmas. Just the label, really. But it's a nice little sessionable beer. Again, connection to Christmas, just the label. Rockin' Rudolph, Hardy and Hansen's. And it was all right. Another sessionable beer. Pretty mundane, but it was kind of a little bit malty, a little bit here, a little bit there, but nothing that would shout it out and kind of would make it memorable, where you could go taste it again and just go, yes, I remember that, I had that and so-and-so date and it was lovely and all that. So on to the next one. They were nice enough, but you know, nothing special. But we've got another one here, Sessionable. 4%. I'm hoping for something here. Again, big Christmas livery on there. Got the Black Sheep. Blitzen, the Black Sheep. Or the Black Reindeer, maybe. I don't know. It's black Sheep with reindeer hat and antlers and that. What does it say? This cheeky festive number has been brewed using a blend of Cascade. Nice. Cascade is often a bit orangey and stuff like that. And Golding's hops. Nice. That'll earthy, bring it down to earth a little bit and bitter it up and everything. Where are we? And a hint of orange peel and muscovado sugar. Ooh. Muscovado sugar is a kind of rummy sort of sugar. Lovely in coffee. Kind of, it almost trickles off the spoon. It's kind of like moist. Get the old BB out. Let's crack this open. I love the crown on these. Kind of Banksy-esque, almost like a kind of tags sort of crown and that to it. There's the digga digga dig. There we go. You got that? Well, yeah. Look at that. Black Sheep Ale, it says, amongst all that. Cat's going bananas again. I'm going to kick her right up the crow's foot. Sorry, but there you go. Can't be bigger than, it can't be a camel's foot, yeah, can it? But anyway, it's only little. So, sorry, I'm get on with it. Then that's what it is, that's what it looks like. Let's pour it out and see what we got. Into GBBF glass. What year was that? 1993. Camera and all that. I think wasn't 1993 when this company was formed? If I remember rightly, somewhere around that. Can't remember. But Black Sheep used to be Feakston's and all that. And he's kind of like gone off and started his own brewery up. Anyway, I do digress. Big Northern Head on it, big fluffy one. But still looking nice, looking kind of doing its own thing. Northern colour as well, so a lot of them seem to be that red colour. So you've got red colour there. And let's put it up against that ceiling. No, you can't see nothing there. Look, can't see a lot. It's dark. Can't see nothing through it. Right. But you can when you hold it up to light. And I can't hold it close enough to the light there to the camera without getting up and moving over to you. So, on my beard, maybe? No, whatever. Beard's white enough nowadays, isn't it? Like Father Christmas. Yeah, it's dying down nicely, it's all okay. Carbonation up against the glass, can't see it, but it's, yep, you can just see it where that light is. Gentle, just tapping away. Right, spin it around, give it a little smell, a twirl and a smell. See what we got. You can smell that Golding's, you can smell. And you can smell the Cascade as well. They're both alive in there. Both married up really nicely. Get a beer like this, and you know, you can smell the difference almost. You can almost smell them next to each other. You know, you can almost smell the stereo coming in. They're not like one punch in on the nose. They're like coming in stereo. Don't ask me what I mean. I don't even know myself. Yeah, nice little slight peppery notes there. You got you're not going to like this, but kind of gently cooked red cabbage as a background note. Then you got little hints of red grape. You got like kind of the tannins you smell on red grapes. You got tiny hints of Garibaldi biscuits. those currants and that, when you get slightly burnt currant. Little biscuity notes in there as well. And that kind of burnt sugar that you get, and kind of coating and glazing the top of biscuits, of the Garibaldis and that. So you got that going on. There's a little bitter edge in there. There's kind of bitter edge of a zest and pith of a pink grapefruit. Plus also little notes of kind of like a tangerine with a couple of cloves in it. You know, that sort of idea. Yeah, just gentle hints of a tangerine, that more slightly, not orangey, but more floral sort of orangey smells. More perfumey, uplifting. But it's all pretty calm and kind of subtle and polite. It's, again, it's not doing like Christmas for me. I don't know what's happening with these. It seems like a lot of beers are putting a label, Christmas label on, and they kind of are hitting the mark. They're hitting the dartboard, but they're not hitting the treble 20s and that. They're just like, boom, oh, I've hit the board again, yay! That sort of idea, you know. But it's all right, it's all good. So let's give it a taste, see what we get. Some beers light you on the nose, and I love that. When you get a beer light you on the nose and you taste it, you go, whoa, whoa, whoa. So let's hope this one's going to do that. Oh, it's very, very different. At the same time, very samey. It's just weird. It's a nice marriage, really nice marriage. There's a little small amount of hops that have been put in there really early, it seems. You know, really early in the brew and that, and they're kind of just a few, and they've got like almost a bitter edge to them, that little dry little note that's like really in there, and little edge tannin, but kind of like a Chardonnay dryness almost, that kind of dry little bitter acid edge to it. They're nice, that's nice. And that's the old Goldings one there, I think. It's Goldings, isn't it? Yeah, Goldings, it's like East Kent Goldings, that one. It's nice little jobby in there, doing its little thing. That's nice. You've got the pith coming out in there again. And that is kind of like off that dryness, tinged in with the Cascade, is giving it an orangey and a grapefruity pith. Little hints of kind of pink grapefruit flesh as well. Nice breakfast grapefruit, you know, when you put your spoon in and it shoots you in the eye, that you can almost, oh, you sod, like that, you know. Juicy sort of thing. Just ruined my shirt now. Yeah, it's nice. It is nice. I'm going to give it another gulp in a minute. It's very gulpable. That's what it is. Very, very gulpable beer. Again, though, Christmas, it's not really what I would call a Christmas beer, in it, you know. But then what is? But how do you describe a Christmas beer? Personally, I always think that a Christmas beer's got to be big, because Christmas is big. Everything you eat and drink at Christmas is big, bigger than and bouncier and more buxom and everything else. Even the missus puts her special bra on and everything else, you know, and all that jazz, you know, and tucks this in and pulls that up and goes to the party like this with everything out, you know. So, sorry, my missus don't have everything out, you know, not even for me. Have I gone too far? Everyone, let me know, because she don't. Right, where have I gone? Right, beer. That's it, back on the subject. Beer. It's a nice beer, though. It is a nice beer. I'm going to give it another gulp, because there's a certain different thing to it. Let's have a little go. in parts, it's a bit wafer thin. It's a nice little dirty, almost metallic edge to the finish. That's nice, nice and dry. There's little hints of kind of something green, like green hoppy sort of hop sort of idea. That green, bitter, early stewed up hop. And when I say green, it tastes green, if you know what I mean. I'm not talking about green hops and fresh or whatever, anything else. Because, you know, just different. I'm talking about a taste of green sort of that green apple edge and things like that. Quite burpy. But not bad. Christmas. Again. I'm not getting on that boat with this. So far I've tried 3 beers, all Christmas beers from Tesco's, from different breweries, and they've not inspired a Christmas feeling or thought in me. You know, they've not gone like, wow, it's Christmas. Whereas something like you drink an Ale Mary, A-L-E, that is just Christmas in a bottle, you know. And there's a few beers that just remind you of Christmas for some reason. So if you're looking for a good beer for Christmas that's mass-produced and ready and waiting for you on most shelves in supermarkets, go and get a Leffe Brune or a Leffe Blonde, but a Leffe Brune even better. Leffe Blonde would go nice with a bit of the chicken and that. Leffe Brune would go in pretty nice with most things, you know, with the chicken and most other things as well. But get yourself that for Christmas, you know. It's got the little top and everything else. Lovely. But yeah, this is all right. It's all right. Give it a try. Do give it a try. So bum 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 bum. Is it that one? Isn't it? Bum bum bum. Blitzen. Yeah, it's try it, bite and like it. See you in the next one. Merry Christmas. Happy New Year. Look after yourself. Be tender and loving to each other. Stop arguing. Don't be naughty. And I'll see you in the next one. Don't be late. Oh, I will start without you. Bye. With a man to the world. With a man for the world. With a man.